You've already learned that a fraction is a number. In this lesson, you'll learn that there is more than one way to write a fraction for any number. When two different fractions name the same number, they're called equivalent fractions. For example, let's look at the fractions 1/2 and 2/4. To represent these fractions, let's start by drawing two number lines that have the same size units. Now let's divide the units on the first line into halves, and divide the units on the second line into fourths. On the first line, we show 1/2 here. On the second line, we show 2/4 here. We can show that the fraction 1/2 is equivalent to the fraction 2/4 like this. The dotted line shows that the point on the first number line for 1/2 is the same as the point on the second number line for 2/4. That means both fractions are expressions for the same point on the number line, which means they represent the same number. In this lesson, you'll learn how to construct a fraction that is equivalent to another fraction. For example, suppose we wanted to find a fraction that's equivalent to 2/4 and has a denominator of 8. We can do this by using number lines. These two number lines are divided into units that are the same size. We divide each unit on the first number line into four equal parts called fourths. Then we count 2/4. On the second number line, we divide each unit into 8 equal parts, or eighths. Now we want to find the place on the bottom number line that's equivalent to the 2/4. Remember, two numbers are equivalent if they are at the same point on the number line. This is the point on the bottom number line that's equivalent to 2/4. We can see clearly that the fractions represent the same point on the number line if we merge the two lines. This point represents the fraction 4/8, and this point represents the fraction 2/4. So 4/8 is equivalent to 2/4. Here's another example. We want to find a fraction that's equivalent to 4/3 and has a denominator of 6. Again, we start with two number lines that have the same size units. First, we want to show 4/3 on the top number line. We divide the line into thirds and count 4/3. Then we divide each unit on the bottom number line into 6 equal parts, called sixths. Now we want to find the number on the bottom number line that's equivalent to 4/3. This point on the number line is equivalent to 4/3. When we count the parts on this line, we get 8. That means this point shows the fraction 8/6. Now, when we merge the lines, we see that both fractions are at the same point on the number line, 4/3 and 8/6. So the fraction 8/6 is equivalent to the fraction 4/3. In the remainder of this lesson, you'll get practice using number lines to find equivalent fractions.